And now we will learn how to record cash-related transactions when you pay from a cash fund. Sometimes this is also called petty cash. Spending cash from a cash fund. Sometimes physically it's the owner's wallet, although it is a good idea to have a separate little lockbox and keep careful tabs and careful track of all the money that comes into and out of the lockbox. The cash on hand, or petty cash, in your QuickBooks records is a bank type of account. Now that makes sense because you deposit money into the account when you establish it and you pay from the account. So making it a bank type of account when you set it up in your chart of accounts allows you to manage it properly. Usually you write a check to establish and set up the fund, and you should record the payments from the fund as an expense type of transaction. Because you're not writing a check, you're paying an expense. The reference number should be the number from the physical cash receipt that you receive when you pay. For example, let's imagine on February 5th, we wrote check number 4 to cash to establish the petty cash fund of $500. Now that means we walked to the bank, we wrote out the check by hand, wrote the payee's name as cash and handed it to the teller, and the teller handed the owner $500 cash from the cash in bank. Well, we can't record this until we set up an account for petty cash. And it's just like we learned before. We click the cog wheel because that's where the settings and setup information is to set up something that we will then use. So we'll then come over and click chart of accounts. Okay, you could also come here by clicking accounting and you would come to the same window for chart of accounts. Once you have your chart of accounts in front of you, click new. Now this type of account will be bank type of account, and cash on hand, there really is no choice for there really is no detail type choice for petty cash, so just leave it as cash on hand. And the name can be cash on hand dash petty cash, depending on the name that you like. Now, save and close, and you can see we now have this account in our chart of accounts to record all the payments from and deposits to the petty cash. Now let's see if we can record this transaction. Well, that's very simple. You write a check. Okay, so again, this time you go to the plus sign and under vendors click check. Now computer remembers it's check number 4, and this is paid to the order of cash. So you could just click add cash and make cash a new vendor so that you can write checks with the name cash. I kind of messed up the capitalization, but don't worry. We know that the date is back on February 5th. Now, the money is coming from the top account, cash and bank, and it's coming to the account down at the bottom. Down here is cash on hand, petty cash. So the top account is where the money's coming from when you're writing a check or paying an expense, and the account down here is where the money is going to. We know the amount is $500. Push tab. Okay, very good. Now when we click save or save and close or save and new, we can come back to the trial balance by clicking reports, my trial balance, and you can see cash on hand, petty cash, shows up for the first time as $500. Now let's record paying from petty cash. Let's imagine on February 6th, we paid $80 cash to Verizon for a prepaid phone card. The place we bought the phone card from gave us a little cash receipt with number 12345 as the receipt number. Well, that's very simple. We click the plus sign, and under Vendors, click Expense. Now, the thing you have to be careful about is which account you're paying from. This is the first time you have to click the pull down arrow and choose cash on hand petty cash as the account we're paying from. Now, you don't always need the vendor's name, so it's nice to choose Verizon. And even though we have unpaid bills that we owe Verizon, this transaction has nothing to do with those unpaid bills. It is still telephone expense in the amount of $80. And of course, I think the receipt number was 12345, reference number 12345. Take a picture of the receipt with your phone and save it, or save the physical receipt itself to match this transaction. And again, don't forget to put the date. The date was February 6th. So let's go back here to February 6th. Okay, very good. So we have whom we paid, where it came from, when we paid, why we paid, how much we paid, and the reference number. Now when we click Save, the results are as exactly as what we would expect. We can close this out. You go back to the trial balance. You see cash on hand petty cash has been reduced by $80 from what we paid down to $420. And you can see telephone expense has increased by 80. It used to be 2,600, now it's 2,680. And just to prove it, I'm going to click on the number, and I'm going to look only at the telephone expense account. These charges to the expense account are from previous bills, but this last $80 is from the February 6th petty cash account, paying that expense. Let's try this one. February 7th, we paid Staples $120 cash for equipment, and Staples gave us a receipt with number 8472. Well, that's very simple. Again, we click the plus sign, we go to expense. We have to make sure that we're paying from the petty cash fund. You don't always need a vendor, but it's nice if we choose Staples. Do not worry about the two unpaid bills. This cash payment has nothing to do with that. And the date this time is February 7, and this time what we're paying for is equipment, a small amount of equipment, which is here. There we go. And the amount we're paying, I believe, is $120. Okay, so now all we have to do is put the receipt number in the field and save the receipt so that this transaction matches the hard copy. And when we save it, petty cash will go down by $120 and become $300. Click Save. Now when we look at the trial balance, you see petty cash on hand has become $300. And if you look at the equipment account and ask why is it 1,215, you can double click and you can see this equipment purchase was from a bill, whereas this equipment purchase was from petty cash on hand. Now let's finish up by replenishing the petty cash fund. Let's imagine on February 8th, the owner withdrew, I guess it's Vonda withdrew $200 from an ATM machine, specifically from the account called Cash and Bank, to replenish the petty cash fund, and here's the slip. And ATM withdrawals, if you haven't guessed already, should be expense type of transactions. And it's very easy to make. We click the plus sign, we click expense. Now we make sure the money is coming from Cash and Bank to the petty cash fund. And then of course we have to put the proper date. There is no payee in this case, or you could put Vonda's name, but you don't have to. Remember, the account on top is where the money's coming from, and the account on the bottom is where the money's going to, and the amount is $200. And because this is a bank transaction where you get a receipt and a slip, 123987 987, and now you recorded all the information about that event, the ATM withdrawal, that you replenished the petty cash fund. After we click Save, we can go back to the trial balance, and you can see petty cash is now up to 500, and cash in bank has been reduced by the 200. Let's double click and check it out. Yep, if you go to the bottom, you can see the last transaction that decreased cash in bank is this 200 to petty cash to replenish the fund.